Greetings, everyone. BJ Weiler, aka Real Millennium Group, back with you here for a another what we are now terming quick play video. 30-minute video just seemed, it seemed all right, but it was a title in progress. But now, yes, quick play video because, you know, we might be less than 30 minutes, we might be more than 30 minutes, as was the case, I think, with our initial quick play of Sid Meier's Railroads. When I decided to start this concept, but yes, our quick play video, short, quick little videos here, anywhere between 20 to 40 minutes is what I'm going to try to average, because, you know, it's all based on time. These aren't going to be streamed. These are basically just going to be recorded for YouTube, because, you know, that quick bit of time doesn't really seem to warrant streaming live, although that might change at some point. But anyway, yes, this is basically, what I'm doing is, you know, the part of the introduction I'm doing for each of the games that I'm doing here for the first time, for a first time quick play for these games, is basically just so I can, you know, if I got a spot of time to be able to pop into a game and play a little bit, then I want to do it instead of having to wait until that game comes up in a streaming schedule, or, you know, these are for games I don't actually have on my streaming schedule yet, but I still want to be able to play, and for those games that are, that, you know, maybe play a little bit more often, that way by the time they come up in the schedule again, I'm not spending, you know, time trying to relearn what I was doing and stuff like that for certain games. So here we go, The Eyes of Aura. Let's get back on with it here, see where we're at here and what we need to do. So, okay, so we've got a light, we've got that. I have no idea what good these things are, but hey, let's see here, anything? Well, I think we read this paper before. This is amazing. It's massive, and there are rooms and passageways everywhere. Mom keeps telling me to do my studies. I think I read this one before. Axel is exploring because he's already gotten himself lost 3 times in the past week. Mom just wants to hear about the ghost. She's convinced the castle is full of spirits and wants to draw their influence in her art. I'm going to go see what I can find. I'll finish my studies later. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. That sounds familiar, so I'm pretty sure we read that note before. Let's see here. I think we finished up this room. Ah, yes, this had the ceiling tile puzzle. I haven't learned the secret of that yet. I'm half tempted to go look that up real quick. That's right, because we clicked all the buttons there. I don't think there's necessarily anything down here. Ah, what's this? I don't recall seeing this before. Okay. Triangle, square, square, X. Okay. Put that in inventory. I wonder if that's a clue to the ceiling puzzle there. Oh, I resume game, thank you. So what did we really got here? So we didn't know. We gotta find something there. 12801, 0 out of 2. think that's pretty much it. So for the scenic puzzle here. Kind of difficult to see stuff here. Ah, here we go. That makes better sense. Okay. Well, it doesn't look like anything that relates to anything in the ceiling puzzle. Do they match? That's the question. Oh, they're all facing in the same direction, it looks like now. Have them all pointing in. Mystery deepens here. Let me see what we can see here, eh? Solve at least one puzzle this quick play session, I would hope. Yes, I know, Firefox not responding because, of course, I want to do some recording here. Oh, for crying out loud. Eyes of Aura, ceiling puzzle. Not seat wing, ceiling puzzle, thank you. 1, 2, 3 tile ceiling puzzle. It's not 6 tiles though, it's 8 tiles. That's not the puzzle I'm looking for. Guess I got that puzzle. Yes, okay, that's where the handle came from, was the drawer we were here for earlier. So we did read that note. There's something interesting here. Did I get that? Let's back up a step here, shall we? I think I did this. Aha! How did I miss that? Searching here. We got that at least. So you didn't do the ceiling puzzle. Interesting. Eight tile. Let's go eight tile. Well, that's six tiles. Well, that's, there's one of six tiles, but it's not. Well, then. We're going to have to try to look that up later so I don't take up too much more time here anyway. All right. We did find something else in this room, so that's something anyway. Okay, let's just head on out here. So let me do this then. Oh, look at that. One of these puzzles. Maybe I have to just have this on. Indeed, okay. There we go. Oop, did it lock up on me? Oh, there we go. All right. All right, so we got something else there. All right. Hello, Isabara. Resume game, thank you. I'm stuck. Okay. There we go. Okay. Oh, okay. Let's see. All right. Anything at all to look up here? We got all three. The gate opens. Excellent. Puzzle, eh? There's a six tile puzzle we had seen before. Now, if I remember how to do it. Yes, continue to the external site. Hurry up. How much space is on the sides too, isn't it? I think that's the key. Aha. Coinage. That's it, huh? Nothing there? Operation. Press to close. Wherever it is, I did it. What's this? Oh, a secret. Well, it tells me how to open the box, but I haven't quite figured that out yet, eh? Okay. I wish it's the stuff I could put in inventory and then whip it out when I'm in front of it. So something with those two. Okay. Yeah, what's this? Yeah, a picture. Excellent. Anything else here? On the floor. Something with these two, it looked like. Ah, okay. I see. Now I see. Okay. So we gotta flip those two. Exactly sure here. Flip the moon in a circle too. Let's see. What did I have there? I'm gonna have to go back and look my video. Nothing yet on that, eh? Okay. So it's the order of the ceiling tiles, too. Try this again, then we'll have to end it here. Top left. You think? Nope, not yet. I still haven't figured this guy out yet. Don't understand what it's trying to tell me. It's got everything scribbled out and it's just got that there. Well, I guess we'll have to figure that out next time. Interesting. Okay. So we still got a few puzzles to figure out here. We got two ceiling tile puzzles now. We got that puzzle to figure out. Nothing else here. Where that is, we closed it. Oh. Would you look at that? Oh. Okay. Interesting. Okay. I guess it's a matter of which one are the right ones. That may open that up. So how do we get over there? That's the question. How do we move those other two? I see a way to get up there. See, they're up there. Manifest. Yeah, so we pretty much had all this stuff. Yeah, this room we solved here. For the most part, I think. Ah. Perhaps that, eh? So there's a green door on the other side. That's got the other ceiling tile, okay. Okay, so we can't get into there. We've done the upstairs rooms, as I recall. A mystery to figure out for next time. Alright, everyone. Of course, next time could be right after this. Depends on when I mash everything together, how many quick plays I get to do, and mash them together for one nice little YouTube video. Oh, I didn't want to do that. Thanks. Meantime, Speed JYR saying thanks for watching this little bit of quick play for the Eyes of Aura. Till next time, I'll see you in game. Greetings everyone, BJ Weiler with you for another quick play with the Eyes of Aura. We're going to see if we can get a couple of things accomplished here this round. Okay, so let's see, the stairs, we got the lasers activated. What are we looking at in here? Door locked, or is this door open? I forget now. Alright, we probably went in here. Found the coins that were in here, which were somewhere. They were in the box. Oh, yes, up there. Which I think we found everything in here. It was interesting. It's here. There's a ceiling puzzle we haven't quite figured out yet. That'll have to be for another time. use handle and pestle, rotate handle 90 degrees. Get upstairs, take disc on balcony, disc on main foyer. Peg opens the office and office, box pulling latch to the right. Take map piece below India, which we figured out. Click reveal book, take disc. In the office desk, take knife in the hallway. Click painting for the cutscene, which we got. Use disc to opens the storeroom, which is that, I believe. I presume is the storeroom. Examine mysterious yellow glow. Take yellow orb, which we've got. Open closet, take handle, which we've got. Push button on the wall above planks, which we did there. Let's head in. Oh yes, we've got the puzzle box to figure out. That's not necessarily above planks. Ceiling puzzle in here as well. That paper we examined, which is supposed to be a clue for this. Let me actually examine this paper again. Anything here? No? Okay. Button on shelves above rolled rug. Take the disc, which we did. Use disc on final peg. Lock room, press button on wall to activate lasers outside, which we did. Note puzzle notes on bookshelf behind spider web. I guess that's what it's talking about. Solve puzzle box using notes. Locked room. I guess this is the locked room, actually. Okay. Activate lasers outside, which we did know. Okay. Let's see what this is. Yeah, this doesn't really help us at all. Because we're looking at it the wrong way. It looks like because this is actually the bottom. And this would be on the left side. This would be the top. So those three are correct. And that just leaves the sun burst pattern. So these instructions don't really help us all. So let's see what we got here. Circle at the bottom. So we gotta switch circle. How am I gonna do this? Let's do this because this goes at the top. Like that. This swings around like that. This guy comes in turn. There we go. Let's say turn, please. Like that. Aha. We have a handle. Take lever arm. Okay. Find lever, handle, and lever arm. Ah, yes. Another lever. That's what that is. That one's complete. This one is not. Now it is. We have two levers. Okay. Excellent. I think we can head out now. Okay, so the clock base we did. That's all done. Take knife, which we did. Take lever. We got. Use and pull the two levers on the locked door under the staircase. Proceed inside. Ah, so we can open that room now. Ah, yes, it does require two levers. I see. Excellent. Enter the locked room. Oh, orbs. No ceiling puzzle in here. Interesting painting. We have something there. That was the way in and out. That's even more interesting, eh? Ah, I think we have something. More coins. Excellent. We're almost halfway to our coin collection here. Anything interesting on the bookshelf? No. Now we got something here. Ah, okay, so another interesting design which we found in one of the other rooms. This way we could put this in inventory and combine this stuff. Why can't we? It looks like we've got something there. Wire from there to there. Anything over here? Apparently not. It looks like this might take another lever or something, huh? Okay. To the right of the rear door. Into the kitchen. Well, how do we know which way is the kitchen? We can go that way. We can go that way. All right, let's see which this is here. Something else there. A very small room. Oh. Okay. Anything in here? No. Nothing there. Dust orbs. Another puzzle box, eh? Aha! Alright, we're halfway through our photograph collection. Oh, paper. I saw one. At first, I thought it was a light attached to the ceiling, but when it noticed me watching, it flew away and went through a hole in the wall. I wonder what it was. Alex is convinced it's one of the castle's ghosts, but I don't think so. I think it's something that Uncle has been working on up in his tower. Still won't let me in there to find out. I think I might have another way in. I've been reading about Lady Catherine, one of the castle's former owners. She is a thing for ghosts as well, and apparently used to lock herself away in a secret room, trying to speak to them until she went crazy. And I think I found it. The room, I mean. I walked around the back of the castle today. There's this big section next to the second floor library that I can't see a way to get to. There must be a secret door somewhere. Maybe if I can get in there, I can find a way into the tower, or maybe the lights really are ghosts and I'll find them hiding in the room. Won't that be something? Indeed. Anything over here? We do have that. Ah. I guess that's not it after all. Okay, interesting. Doesn't appear to be. Anything else we can examine in here? Okay. This is where we just went, isn't it? Yes, okay. Just making sure here, okay. Guess this would be into the dining room. Oh. Ah, so that's where they're traveling through there. All right, something there. Oh, what's this? Something shiny, but how do we open it? Maybe this opens it somehow. Okay. A blank painting. Like in the other room. Coins. What's this? Oh, this might tell us the secret of the wall outside. See through dining room to the kitchen. Note the lock chest on the floor along the way. Note book about tiles in the hallway. Collect six green gems in this room. We're in the kitchen. Locked chest. Oh, history and legend. Oh, look at this. Engravings, frescoes, and panels. While most surfaces in the castle present a bare brick or wood face, a consequence of the castle's geography and economically remote location, there are none in the less of a variety of notable details we found for those who take the time to look. Perhaps most striking is the frequency of celestial and astrological iconography, suggesting many inhabitants of the castle have maintained a connection with the night sky. We will return to this topic in chapter 12. More typical designs can also be found. Take for instance the wood paneling shown in the following photographs, which demonstrate artwork typical of the castle and other residences in the surrounding area. Figure 1 shows a basic design, a square of 9 icons in a regular pattern. The pattern of figure 2 is more complex. Pay particular attention to how directionally the icons is used to lead the viewer's eye. Beginning in the top left corner and following one by one to the bottom right. What is unclear, however, is if this snaking pattern is intentional or yet another example of one of the castle's occupants altering the aesthetic for their own pleasure. So top left, flying one by one to the bottom right. Okay. So that's the solution to the two ceiling puzzles, eh? Nothing else going on in here. Okay, well, this might be a good place to stop this episode then. Oh, look at that. Another photograph. Excellent. Ah. Another one of you. I should take a screenshot of this. This might help. Alt, print screen, paint. Thank you, paint, but no. There we go. Probably what I should do for these other papers, huh? Save. Book ceiling puzzles. Save. Okay, good. That's probably what I should do is go find those other scraps of paper. Like that one, Alt, print screen. scrap of the paper too. Scrap paper pattern 2. Okay. Save. Let's go find the other one. Oh, we are standing in a new position, are we not? Yes, this was it. Okay. Alt. Print screen. Save as. The paper pattern. 1. Save. Excellent. Alright, we're good there then. Let's head back out to the foyer. And we'll pick up from there. Again. Alright, thank you for watching this episode, everyone. This little quick play. Till next time, it's BJ Wiresign. I will see you in game.